What's up fam, The Real Rahim here. Welcome and great to have you guys here for another episode, because today we're going to be talking about 5 items you can upgrade on your DJI FPV goggles for $55. Let's go. For those new here, this channel is all about FPV, be it DJI FPV, traditional FPV, and even some line of sight. So do join me by subscribing down below. Okay, so let's get talking about the upgrades. I'll go from the cheapest to the most expensive. Everything is gonna be in US dollar, and if you want more info, just click on the description down below. First up is gonna be the lens cover. I got it 3D printed from a friend of mine. Of course, I mean it's free, but more or less it should cost you about $3. It holds your 4 stock antennas and also 2 SD cards. Next up is gonna be your Sunny Life battery clip. It fits your stock batteries. It has a neat area for you to tidy up your wires, and it clips at the rear of your goggle strap with an additional rubber pad at the back so that it can sit against your head comfortably. This is gonna cost you $6. Now, item number 3 is a must for your DJI FPV goggles. I found that the stock rubber sponge, I don't know what you want to call it, doesn't really form fit to my face. There were still gaps here and there, and they will tend to leave like hard marks on your face after prolonged wear. So for me, I have upgraded to this foam, which I got from Just Fly FPV. Now you can have a look at their Facebook page. I'll leave a link down below. I got them for $12. The pro about this sponge is that it's removable, washable, and form fitting, so that there are no light leaks, or at least for my face. And at the same time, the most important thing for me is that these gaps can give way for my specs. That means I do not need to take off my specs when I'm wearing these goggles. Win. But of course, this is subjective. Different people may have different kind of specs. For me, these are a godsend, right? Do give Just Fly FPV, find Daniel Masri, give him some love. Okay, so fourth item on the list is an iFlight strap. It's an upgrade for me because I kind of did not prefer the strap that was the stock DJI strap. Yeah, I know it had three harness points, okay, one more on top, but it kind of, okay, this one is just a small metal, like, it kind of messes up my hair, so I didn't like using that strap. So for me, choosing a strap to upgrade was something that needed time and research, because you do not want to get anyhow a strap that may not work with your stock mounts. Now, since I know that I'm mounting a battery at the back, and I prefer this kind of only single hoop kind of strap, I had to make sure that it is this kind non-removable, because I don't want to have that kind of Velcro like the original strap from the DJI. It was a Velcro by the sides. So if you had tightened it too much and there was too much tension, right, the Velcro is going to give way. So definitely prefer, if you're looking for a strap, you don't exactly need to be getting this iFlight strap. There are many more out there. Just make sure that it's also going to be coming in with an open hoop like this, okay, non-removable. Not bad of a deal. This strap together with the aluminium mounts costs about, I think it was $15. It even has an additional hoop by the side in case you want to run the Fat Shark kind of batteries. Okay, I'll show you an example. Okay, not exactly a Fat Shark, but this is a Yixin battery pack for their goggles. You can just mount it at the hoop. It fits just fine, right? And then the plug goes in and powers your goggles. Now, last on the list is this Team Black Sheep power cable, which I am not exactly using right now because I'm kind of already loving the battery pack from DJI. But what's so special about this cable is that besides having your common standard plug, it has a power button, a touch button, and also the end connects to a LiPo. Okay, this is only for guys who have spare LiPos lying around, especially for the FPV pilots. You can use this as its full length, or you can actually detach. This goes directly into the goggle, and then your LiPo can plug in here and mount it at the back of your goggles. I've tried using it for a while. I think somebody did ask me in one of the comments, but I don't prefer it because firstly, the cable has just a bit too much material, I guess. There's this additional plug included, which is actually to power the Fat Shark goggles, the fan on top. Why I don't like this is because of the touch sensor. Okay, it's not a physical switch, it's actually just a touch on and off. One thing that I've ever encountered is that, check out the length. Now you're gonna be having this cable by the side of your head. Sometimes this may hit my neck or whatsoever, maybe resting somewhere or whatever how your configuration is. This may actually be activated, or should I say deactivate the battery and by its touch sensor. So after a few incidences that had me having blackouts of the screen, luckily it's a DJI FPV, I can just press the pause button and then switch on the goggles again. So kinda not preferred, but this is just my opinion on things. It just doesn't work out for me, so maybe it works out for you, alright, who knows. So anyways, this is gonna cost you $18. You can go and have a look at it at the Team Black Sheep website. Links down below. Okay, so let's wrap this up by just saying that you do not need to spend the $55 to get all these upgrades, but for me as a seasoned FPV pilot, I have some conveniences that for me form fitting is the most important, so that there are no light leaks to give you that full immersive feel. The convenience of a single hoop, right, no other straps all over the place, and having a battery at the back. Okay, why so? Because this is how often FPV pilots will carry around their goggles, right? See, nice and neat, no cables hanging all over the place, nothing that's gonna get stuck anywhere. I've had a number of times that my controller get stuck on the cable and I pull it away and it unplugs. If it unplugs, it's fine. If you tear the cable or spoil the plug, then even worse, okay? So this is the convenience that I'm paying for. Most useful is when bad weather comes along and you suddenly have to pack up everything. All you need to do is worry about your drone, pack it up, and go and find shelter, alright? This part is then you can pack it in later, get your lens cover, put on the antennas, and it just slides right in. Convenient. Battery pack goes behind, everything goes into the bag. You're done. Well, that reminds me, I haven't made an episode on that. What's in my drone bag? Gonna add that to the schedule, but for now, if you've liked this video, do give me a thumbs up. Thumbs up especially if you wanna see me create that episode. Now, if you've not subscribed, there'll be more FPV, DJI FPV content, and also some line of sight content coming up, so do join me by subscribing down below. Now, if you wanna chat with me, do leave me a comment and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And pilots, as always, I'll see you in the skies. Peace.